Everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. In the last episode, we created that really nice shoe bench to help organize the entryway to our garage. And once I got it in place, I noticed we still have a little bit more storage that we need to take care of. So I noticed my wife had these great little baskets kind of sitting around, and I thought, you know what would be really neat is to take these, they're not being used right now, create some sort of storage that goes up and above, and we could use these to, say, store gloves, hats, scarves, whatever, but more importantly, help again organize that area so that it's a little bit more user-friendly. So we've turned to our stash, pulled out some great maple once again, and we built what essentially is just a simple box with an applied detail in the front. So let's go ahead and jump right into the episode and take a look at how we did this. Today's project is yet again another opportunity to burn through my stash of hard maple, and it begins with resawing these thicker boards down to size. Once I have them milled close to the final dimension, I glue together the panels and then set those aside, and once they're dry, I'll plane them down to their final thickness. Next, it's time to cross-cut them to length, starting first with squaring up one end, and then sliding the rip fence over the desired dimension and carefully making the second cut. All that remains now is to simply rip the panels to their final width. So sticking with the theme of simple joinery for our current projects, I'm opting to use another modified butt joint by assembling the project using my biscuit joiner. While the project was dry assembled, I penciled in some matching reference lines in the mating pieces, and now it's a matter of lining those up with the marks in the biscuit joiner and then cutting the slots. For these side pieces, this is a lot easier to cut these slots simply because they're lying flat. For the complementary slots in the top and bottom, it takes a little more effort to stand the biscuit joiner upright, line up the reference lines on both the stock and the tool, and then plunge the blade without unintentionally angling it slightly during the cut. And this is even with the guide fence referencing the stacked boards for extra support. With all the slots cut, I did a dry fit to check alignment, and then it was onto the glue up. So perhaps the most frustrating part after all these years of using biscuits is I still tend to overdo it with the glue on the first few, so this first end gets a bit more in the slots than is actually needed. So as soon as I push the biscuits in there, you can see the excess squeeze out come out. So for the remaining slots, there's no need to apply extra glue on the board's surface, as plenty will be available to spread out. To attach the mating pieces, I add glue directly to the slots, again trying to avoid too much squeeze out. Then it's a matter of lining up the mating slots and dropping the component in place. Since sometimes the biscuits begin to swell from the water and the glue, they need a little extra help to slide in position. Once it's fully seated, the side is just a pinch out of alignment on this one, so I'll use the small mallet I turned a few years ago to help persuade it into place. With the first side set, it's time to repeat the process at the other end, including the use of a little persuasion to line it all up. Now the final step in this glue-up is of course to add the top, which includes a little finesse to line up the slots, a bit of pressure to bring it together, and of course, just a little more persuasion. Then while it sits in the clamps to dry, I turn my attention to making the applied molding for the front edge. Using some leftover half-inch stock from the shoe bench build, I angle the blade on the table saw, set up a feather board, and then carefully make this first cut. Ordinarily, I would only raise the blade just enough to cut through the face of the stock, but to clear the kickback pawls, I need to raise it just a pinch higher this time. Now all that's left is to rip the stock to width. Over at the miter saw, we'll cut the initial 45 degree angles for the corners. Since I only need one complete corner to be done to start measuring the remaining pieces, after completing the bottom and first side, I clamp them in position, which then allows me to mark the location of the cut on the top piece. Once I have that, it's back to the miter saw, then a quick dry fit to confirm it's good, followed by clamping it in position, which will then allow me to measure, mark, and eventually cut the remaining side to complete the frame. With all four pieces cut and clamped, it's a matter of gluing them together and then attaching them to the frame on the front of the case. All that remains now is to simply add this board across the top on the inside using pocket hole joinery, which will then give us something to securely attach it to the wall. All right, folks, and that's all there is to the construction of this great little storage unit. I mean, ultimately, as I mentioned before, it's just a box. But adding this little applied detail molding to the front of it, I think it makes it look like a much nicer box when it really comes down to it. Ultimately, it's your decision how you want to put this together if you end up creating this. One thing for certain, again, we just used this regular butt joint here on the sides to bring the sides, the top and the bottom together. But because the sides, you're going to be gluing an end grain to a long grain, that's where it's really important to say have some sort of modification in there, either a biscuit joint, a dowel, maybe you're gonna use pocket hole joinery, because we all know, or should know by now, that if you're gonna be gluing end grain to the long grain, what ends up happening is that at some point that's gonna fail because that glue is just gonna get sucked down through the end grain. So there's maybe some techniques to help kind of close off that end grain, but for certain, I think ultimately using some sort of reinforcement and there's some sort of modification to help reinforce that joinery is really going to make a huge difference. Either way, it's a really fun project. It's something you can knock out pretty quickly and get up in place and utilize as quick as you want. So until the next time, straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.